What's going on, fight fans? It's fight week for Shakur Stevenson versus Edwin De Los Santos. We also get a doubleheader effect with Manuel Navarrete versus Robson Cassacio. All that and more on this episode of Sports Social Live. Subscribe, like, share. Thank you for coming through. What's going on, fight fans? It's Lance Hayes with another boxing episode of Sports Social Live. And in this episode, we're going to discuss the Shakur Stevenson versus Edwin De Los Santos doubleheader with Manuel Navarrete versus Robson Cassacio. I'm excited for this card. I think that they did a phenomenal job of gathering two solid fighters and putting them on the same card in Vegas on a Thursday night. Again, this fight will be on a Thursday night, so it's going to be a little bit weird, a Thursday night fight in Vegas during football season. I had to slow down just because I had to think about it and conceptualize that. Vegas during football season is a tough one. You have the Bengals playing the Ravens, and I'm skeptical, but how would they have known when they probably made this fight? They might have known, but it's okay. I think it's more of an infrastructure building for both Shakur and Manuel Navarrete to go forward with Thursday night fights in Vegas. I don't see it being a bad thing for the fight card because it seems to have a good push in the Twitter kind of atmosphere and around Facebook pages and everything in between. I even saw a couple of people talk about it on Twitch. So this fight card, I am excited for this fight card just because I'm really interested in seeing Shakur and how he's able to come out and fight Edwin De Los Santos. Does he just masterclass De Los Santos? Does he put on a stopping performance and more like Yoshino and just the ref has to come in and stop the fight? Does De Los Santos come out, surprise us, and make Shakur have to work a little bit harder than he's worked in the past for his fights? I'm interested to see how this fight kind of presses out for Shakur and De Los Santos. De Los Santos can crack. He's shown he can crack. He's shown he can get in the pocket. He can sit on his punches very well. Shakur has the best defense probably ever, they say, top five ever from CompuBox. If you believe those statistics, I don't mind statistics. It shows me trends. And Shakur has the best defense that has ever graced the boxing ring. So, well, one of the best defenses that has ever blessed the boxing ring. So I'm excited to see how these fighters are able to come out and compete. You have to watch them compete. You have to watch them. This is a good fight for boxing fans and a good test for Shakur Stevenson. But, what about the buildup of the fight? Let's go into detail about the buildup of a fight. Shakur Stevenson and Edwin De Los Santos have been building the fight more so on the Shakur Stevenson side. I haven't seen much from Edwin De Los Santos, but they have been building this fight up solidly, in my opinion, for what the fight is. It is a Thursday night fight. The buildup has stretched kind of over time, but it's been a more of an organic buildup to more lifestyle events, and I like what they've done with that. I like the interviews that have come out from this fight. I like Shakur's at the Vegas Raiders games. They're at basketball. I think he was at a basketball game, and the interviews have been solid that I've seen thus far. Haven't seen much from De Los Santos. I would have loved to see more on my Spanish-speaking pages, but maybe I missed it out there. But I've seen bits and pieces throughout my international kind of boxing friends, and it's been a nice slow buildup. It hasn't been the massive mega card buildup. No, I'm not saying that, but it has been a decent build. More so on the undercard, you see a lot of the undercard fighters getting more publicity. Emiliano Vargas been out there talking. You see Abdullah Mason. I don't think he was talking, but a lot of people are mentioning his name in the Twitter sphere. If you searched each one of the fighters' names, you do see people mentioning them. So the decent build and organic build by the undercard fighters has kind of helped propel this fight into more of that value card that a lot of boxing fans want and that we need for boxing. This is a foundational building card, and I'm okay with it. I'm okay with it. So going forward, the undercard shaping up nicely, and I spoke on those undercard fighters getting out there and making their rounds in media. I like that the undercard fighters are discussing this. And I like that Top Rank is pushing these undercard fighters kind of better than they have been before. A lot of times I felt like they were just pushing up undercard fighters that just weren't good to me. But it seems like this set of undercard guys are solid. Like each one of them can hold their own, and it seems like they're a better prospect card, better kind of stable prospects right now. And the fights seem to be a talented matchup rather than them fighting these tomato cans. Like that one fight last week with the guy with the big, the man breasts was fighting last week. He looked like he was out of shape. I think Top Rank matched these guys well this week for the Shakur card and providing that Thursday night value going forward. So I'm excited for that. I'm also just really pumped up to see El Vaquero versus Robson Cassacial on the undercard. If you can even call it an undercard, because for me, it's a doubleheader. And a lot of the Hispanic fans out there are, you got to enjoy seeing that. If you're a boxing fan, period, you got to enjoy seeing Emmanuel Navarrete fighting El Vaquero. First of all, dude rolls in, cowboy hat, chilling, repping the fans. This is one of the most kind of, he should be a beloved fighter for Mexican fans out there, Hispanic fans. Dude is just, seems humble on his stuff. He's confident. I like how he just carries himself. If you're from Texas, I'm from Texas. I've seen these type of guys everywhere with the cowboy hats. You see them at bars like Ojos Locos, Hooters. They're sitting there with Coronas, Cervezas. They have the girls there. So I like seeing that Emmanuel Navarrete type guy just going out there and cracking and punching with volume, just head. But it's not, it seems like a smart intellectual volume, because he was able to go to his corner in that last fight with Valdez with one hand, and they were able to kind of throttle his effective scoring. And with that volume, he was able to go out and do well. He actually uses some defense and footwork to get out of trouble with Valdez, who kept coming forward with that kind of pressure fighting. He was able to kind of spin Valdez around and then step on the gas and get that volume out. Entertaining fighter. So I'm excited to see him versus Cassacial. Cassacial is that Olympic point fighting from Brazil. He's able to kind of get in there and fight. He shouldn't have a loss against Valdez had he fought a smarter fight. And I think that's what's going to get Cassacial in trouble against Vaquero, because he's probably going to be out there. He's going to be like, okay, he can handle Navarrete's power, but then that volume that comes with that power is just going to wear him down over time if he allows it to. So Cassacial can't do what he did previously before against Oscar Valdez, which is where he kind of took his foot off the gas and Valdez was able to capture those last rounds. I mean, at one point he put his hands up in the air like he had already won the fight, which was crazy when you're fighting in the fighter's backyard. That was the dumbest thing I've ever seen. So Cassacial has to fight a full 12 rounds in this fight if he wants to be successful, because El Vaquero is not stopping. He's going to put his foot on gas, keep coming forward, and make Robson Cassacial pay if he's not focused every minute of the fight. One thing you got to give Emmanuel Navarrete's corner is that they are able to convey their ring direction to him really well. They know he's a volume puncher, but they're able to tell him, like, hey, back off a little bit. I loved how they were talking to him in his last fight against Valdez. They're like, hey, calm down, back off. We know your hands hurt. They asked what's wrong with him. Then they gave solid, quick, informative direction to him. And Navarrete went out and actually listened. And a lot of fighters lately have not been listening to their corners, which has spelled disaster for some of these big fights. I like how Navarrete was able to kind of rely on his corner and confidently and effectively utilize that direction that he's been given. So Cassacial is going to have to be on point, because Navarrete's corner is one of the smarter kind of corners that I've seen controlling their fighter, who's a volume kind of unorthodox fighter. I'm excited to see how he's able to go out there, and I'm excited to see what the team is able to put up. I know Cassacial is going to give a fight. We know it. Everybody knows Cassacial is not going to play around with this fight. And Cassacial needs this name building. So the undercard is shaping up pretty nicely. Continuing on with the undercard, let's discuss some of the undercard people. I mentioned Emiliano Vargas on the undercard and Abdullah Mason. If you don't know the guy, check him out. Abdullah Mason. I just Twitter, Instagram. Dude is cold.
YouTube, I just always search, and I've seen this guy coming up, and I'm excited to see how he's able to fight on this card. It's going to be great. He's fighting Jose Maria Cardenas. So this undercard is shaping up to be something quite serious for prospects and those in between. And you do have a world title fight on the card. So you can't beat that with a stick if you ask me. Moving forward, and our last thing we'll talk about, the betting lines. I like making money. You like making money. I like this card because the betting line for the Shakur De Los Santos is at over and under is at 10.5. Everything I mentioned before, and I'll speak on it now, came into play when I made my decision of pressing the over for this fight. I'm shooting for the over for this fight of over 10.5. I love Shakur's defensive skill. I love Shakur can crack. Shakur is one of the best fighters out there in boxing. However, I don't think Shakur is going to go in here and just sit on punches like he did with Yoshino. I don't think Shakur is going to just do that. I think he's probably going to overwhelm with skill, masterclass, and get to the decision. That's what I'm seeing. I don't think Edwin De Los Santos will let Shakur just sit on those punches in there. Even though he has the defensive skills, Shakur has been hurt when he decided to kind of get in there and sit on punches. He can do it. I know he can. But I don't think it's worth it to kind of get in that mix when you're already in a masterclass stance. Go the 12 rounds, put on a show for the fans, and get everybody their money with his over. So I'm shooting for the over on this card. I'm thinking Shakur is going to go out there, put on a phenomenal performance. De Los Santos is going to make Shakur work as much as he can, and then we're gonna get a great fight out of it as fight fans. I'm gonna go with the over on this one. I'm also gonna hit the over on Navarrete and Conceicao. I just don't see the under being hit on that. Robeson Conceicao is a smart fighter. Don't think he's gonna get crushed out there. Although that's a kind of a tough one as well. Well, not a tough one as well, but it's kind of a tough one because you can see Robeson Conceicao kind of falling into that trap of Navarrete. All right. That concludes and wraps up this episode of Sports Social Live. Boxing is my passion, football my passion. We cover everything from boxing to football and anything in between. I'm Lance A, Sports Social Live. Subscribe, like, share. Let's get it.